Alright, so hey guys, and welcome back to Let's Play Resident Evil Zero. And it has been quite a while from the last episode. Yeah, I don't even remember the buttons here. I'm, you know, pressing a bunch of nonsense. But so what I believe happened in the last one was that we made our way to the basement, fought off a couple hunters, and collected the water key. And now our main objective here is just to collect all of the stone tablets so we can make our way out of the facility through the third floor and, you know, see what happens next. But yeah, so I mean, it's been quite a long time since the last one, obviously. You know, haven't recorded in a long while. It's been like 3 months, but I mean, I know I did promise this in the last one, but you know, should be getting back on the grind, so expect many uploads to be coming out. A lot, like, I just expect uploads to be a lot more frequent. I'm getting back on it, and I'll be in the sitting recording, like, I don't know, probably 2 or 3 episodes, because I want to, you know, have a whole, I can't think of the word here, just a bunch of episodes coming out one after another, so I can, you know, kind of redeem myself after the long 3 month break I took. But yeah, we're back on it, and here we are in the center room with the puzzle. Now, basically what you want to do is just light the first one. It's kind of like a which one is stronger than the other puzzle here, but I believe the weakest one of all of them, and the first one we want to light, is the reindeer, actually, or the deer. I don't know why I said reindeer. Guess I'm just that into the Christmas season with all and all that, with horns probably displayed. Yeah, I know, because normally to find the lowest one, you basically, the weakest one in the chain, you just kind of go to the one that doesn't say it's stronger than anything. Like all the other animals here, when you read their descriptions, will talk about how they are stronger than a different one. So for the this one for example, my sharp wits allow me to take down even the greatest horned beast, which of course is referring to the fact that he's able to just like beat the deer. And I think next is the horse. My no amount of cutting can match the speed of my supple limbs. Right, which means that, I guess, I mean, that one doesn't really, I feel like that one's kind of harder to figure out, because it isn't really, I mean, it's kind of hard to figure out that one would be implying anything about the wolf, but it does. This one is next. I didn't even read the description, though, but it's just, I am the king of all I survey, no creature can escape my grasp. This next one is, I can creep up on my victims in legless silence and conquer even the mightiest of kings with my poison, which of course is referring to the fact that he can beat the, you know, I'm not even sure what that other animal over there is, like a bear or leopard or something. I don't even know. I probably sound stupid. But the last one, of course, here, I'm not even going to read the little description, is the bird or hulk or hawk or vulture. I said hulk, I say, but yeah. So here you have two rooms. I think I'm going to go into this one, though. This one, I don't actually think has anything other in it other than a file, but obviously I want to collect everything there is to collect in the game, which includes the files. And oh my gosh, Rebecca is actually wasting all her ammo here. Oh my lord. All right, that was not really the best. Rebecca's kind of wasting all of her supplies, but whatever. I'm sure there's plenty of shotgun ammo in this facility. But management trainee's diary. What is it that Director Marcus is researching all the time? And what's with his weird interest in leeches? Interest seems more like love at times. Rumor has it that there's something dangerous about those leeches. Is it true that when Dennis just touched one, he got ill with the fever? Again today, there were those horrible moans beyond that door. Let sleeping dogs. No way I'll go near them. Even if the director ordered me, I don't want to end up like Dennis. That poor bastard. Scratching makes me itch just watching him. Must maybe go if can, but who? I think how. Dennis gone, I go hungry. Help, Mom. Well, I mean, yeah, that's kind of upsetting, you know, reading that, but you know, your man's infected with the virus from the leeches. He was ordered to go near them, and I'm guessing he did, or what might actually happen is that Dennis got to him, right? Because he's infected. I don't know. I probably sound ridiculous. Like, I don't even know what I'm talking about, but I'm just trying to make sense of an obscure note here. Anyway, I don't see. I got a new mic. You can probably tell, which I didn't even point out. But I do. I'm recording with a different mic, and you know, I also have a new pair of earphones, right? And basically, I can, like, the audio in this headset is like super, super loud. Or it's not really like a headset because it doesn't really have a mic, but earphones or whatever, I don't really know what to call them. I just call it headset even though there's no mic, but yeah, headset is super loud. So basically, like whenever Rebecca moves, I think there's like a zombie creeping up on me, but in actuality, it's just my teammate. But yeah, that I didn't even mention. I got so sidetracked on like my, you know, setup that I forgot to even mention the fact that we just picked up one of the three stone tablets. So that's one down, two more to go. So now we can actually leave the basement here and start making our way back up to the second floor. So we can actually unlock a new area of the training facility with the water key that we picked up in the last episode. But I mean, this next area, wait, what's my inventory looking like? Okay, yeah, I'm full, so I'm gonna have to get Rebecca to pick it up. But this next and new area of the training facility is actually pretty full of Leechmen or Mimicry Marcuses. I don't really know what I referred to them as in the other episodes, but I mean, I guess the official name is Mimicry Marcus, but I kind of just go with the Leechman. It's more easier to understand, I guess. It's just like, it's pretty much what everyone calls them. You know, when I watch like retrospectives or reviews of the game, I always just hear everyone referring him to that, so I'll just copy the trend and just go with the Leechmen. But basically, yeah, this next area that we'll be unlocking has lots of Leechmen, so we're definitely going to want to come in prepared, and all we really have on us is an empty shotgun and a handgun, which isn't exactly a lot, but I can actually take these Molotovs here, which are super effective when you use them against the Leechmen, so that should be good. Make sure to drop. Do I want to leave the shotgun? I might actually leave it, and I'll leave one herb, and I'll just equip this, and then we can get started on making our way to this next area, which is actually just over here on the second floor, in the room where we found the grenade launcher is the door we need to go through. Oh my god, that scared me so bad with how like hearing like the bugs in my ear, and also how like the music. That sound effect right there, that is horrifying. And because I have the headset so loud, like, oh my god. I'm also recording during the day, but I have my curtains closed and it's all silent, so that scared me so bad. Thought there was like something real. That I'm just jumpy today. I think that's all it is. But I continually am getting jump scared. My heart is like pounding. Yikes. Okay, there actually is one around this corner as well, so I gotta be prepared for that. Just gonna start throwing. I can't even see. Is it still alive? Apparently. Can't even see anything. Nah, we're still fine. I'm like, Rebecca's so weak, though. I actually thought we put the caution with just one hit. Because I swear, you get like, oh my god, there was one on me. Yikes. But yeah, I think this is actually the room where Wesker and Birkin were during the train sequence, but oh my gosh, now we're cautioned, but yeah, they're not here anymore. I guess a Leechman decided to go after them. Yeah, Marcus sent a Leechman after Wesker, but it takes three Molotovs, I believe, to take care of these guys, and I only have two, so I'm gonna have to just start going ham with the pistol. Oh my gosh, Billy, come on, man. Alright, yeah, this is not going the best. I should actually get out of here fast. All right, and we're back. Now, I mean, I already took care of the leech man in this hallway, and I already managed to, you know, go into this room and grab the vice handle, but yeah, I died, as you saw, and basically what I did to end is I just kind of, you know, went out of my way to grab some more supplies and health, but sorry, I was just finishing off a drink there, super unprofessional, but it's done now. But yeah, so I, you know, went into the main room and just grabbed a bunch of supplies and health, and you know, just basically you know, just came in a lot more prepared and was able to, you know, take care of that leechman pretty simply. But yeah, I mean, I'm not even really sure how I died. I feel like I got kind of cheated there, but whatever. I mean, we didn't make too much progress, so it wasn't, like, too much of a struggle to actually make my way back to where we were, but, it wasn't fun either. But here we, you know, want to make sure that we, like, split up the characters, keep one character, which is Bailey, because he can't play, you know, Rebecca can't actually play the piano for some reason, which is, you know, I'm not going to be the millionth guy to go into that whole, you know, tangent about how, oh, Rebecca plays it in Resident Evil 1 and now she can't in this game. Yeah, it's weird, but she can't play it in this game where she can in Remake, and it's kind of an inconsistency considering it, you know, that game takes place the day after this, but she can't for some reason, so we have to use Billy to take care of it instead. But we want to make sure he's out there so that when we take this battery, because yes, when we take this battery, the door will close behind us, and well, we won't really be able to escape if we have, you know, both characters in here. But of course, if you have both characters in here, you can always just put the battery back and the door will open. But we want to leave with the battery in hand, and to do so, we need to play the piano again. I don't really want to watch the cutscene again, so if I can just skip it, yes, that would be great. I mean, I'll obviously show it once just so we can see the cutscene, because I'm going to be showing off every cutscene in this Let's Play, of course, because I want to show off everything, but yeah. I don't think we need to watch the same cutscene on repeat twice. You know, we've seen it once, that's good enough. But now, using the vise handle we got, we can... Oh my gosh, Billy. Sometimes the AI in this game is just so ridiculous. Like, I hate how your character, like, your teammate will just start shooting and wasting ammunition on, such minor enemies like that. But I'm just gonna exchange this like that. See, use 15 bullets. Jeez. I'll give Billy one herb. I'll quickly switch characters just to reload. And I'll switch back to Rebecca. And then we can make our way into this room first. You don't have to go into this room first, but I just want to clear it out because it's the one that has all the health in there. And there is a couple zombies in the other room, so if I get bit, I want to make sure I have health on me. But I don't think I'll be bit. I'm going to be able to dodge. I'm sure of it. But, yeah, I'll actually do that. There is a reason, because I'm, you know, kind of struggling to juggle the inventory here, basically, because there are, as you can see, two herbs in there, and I kind of have to make sure there's some open spaces for Rebecca, but I think I got this. I kind of figured out how I'm going to do this. So I need to make sure, though, I pick the red herb up first. It has to be the red herb, or else this is not going to work. And, there we go. Combine this with this, and I'm actually going to pick up this here first as well, so that we can have more Molotovs on us. So just combine this with, or this, sorry, with this, and then it already goes into the stack, and then we can just carry around this last herb, and yeah, that should be good. But oh my god, you actually take a listen to the music here, it is so creepy. Oh my gosh. I was trying to like... I had the game paused there. I was trying to like unmute my mic, but... Yeah, I kind of learned my lesson. I wanted you guys to listen to the super atmospheric music, but I learned my lesson to not really mute my mic, because then when I go into the next room, I'm going to be brutally attacked like I was there. Yeah, that was not fun at all. Hopefully Billy's okay, because that was crazy. Oh my gosh. But yeah, all I really wanted to do was show up, but I think I'm looking quickly just in retrospect here. You know, I'm not sure, but I think I might have actually unmuted, then unmuted my mic again. Like, just, it was, a lot, you know. I think I kind of messed up, but it's whatever. Sorry, am I full on spaces, Bill? I might be, so I'm just gonna quickly go over here and use... Oh, I'm not even. So, just wanna... You kind of have to be, like, perfectly staying in front of it, which I don't like, but... There we go, we can just quickly use the, vice grip here and drop the stone tablet. So there's only one more we have to get, and this next one is probably the easiest and the most quick to grab. You know, you don't really have to do too much. You can pretty much, just do this last one really quickly and easily, so... Let's go ahead and do that. So now to actually do this last one, all you want to do is just make your way to the main foyer, and then you can exit the front door, and then, you know, obviously, you know, it seems like, you know, you can easily leave the property, but obviously you can't, because I think the bridge is down or whatever. But instead, there is, you know, some platforming you can easily do to just quickly nab yourself the final stone tablet, and then we can actually start making our way out of this training facility to the new location. And the next location in the game is the shortest, but it does house a pretty cool boss fight, which I'm pretty stoked to take on, so I want to make sure I can get out of here and get onto that as soon as possible, obviously. But we're also coming to the fact that we're leaving this facility, which means that we're coming to one of the worst aspects of the game, and that's, of course, you know, the inventory management. We're gonna have to, you know, send all of our items. We're gonna have to be pretty careful with, you know, we're gonna have to take, basically what I'm trying to say here, and I'm failing and, you know, continually stuttering and just messing this up so badly, but all I'm trying to really say here is just that we're going to have to take a couple items with us, obviously, because we're leaving, but we want to be careful with what we take, because this boss fight is kind of tough, so we want to make sure we have the right amount of heals and the right amount of ammo, obviously, to bring with us. And especially because I don't save between episodes, this is going to be really risky for me, because if I mess this boss fight up, I have to redo all the progress I made in this episode, plus the progress I make in the next episode, so I really got to be careful about dying and hope that I really don't, and that I can, despite this being a pretty, you know, troublesome and hard to do fight, I do this successfully and can actually take him on. But, you know, we're not there yet, so I don't have to quite worry about it. But what I do want to do is make sure that I take something so Billy at least has one open slot. Because he's the one I think who has to push the block. Or maybe Rebecca does have the strength to push these blocks. I'm not sure. I'm just gonna split up so that Rebecca doesn't get in the way and annoy us while we're trying to solve this block puzzle here. I mean, there's not really too much of a puzzle to it. All you want to do is just continually push this down until you hit the guardrail here, and then you just push it all the way left from this direction, and then you just keep pushing it until it smacks into the other guardrail, and then you're pretty much done and can get the last stone tablet. So it's definitely the easiest one to collect of all three. Don't really have to put too much effort. No, actually, we're gonna have to push it down a little bit more. So just keep pushing it until it gets about there. Perfect, I think, actually. I think that was 100% perfect. Oh, just a little bit too much to the left, but it's okay. Just push it. Oh, I might have actually overshot it there. I just, like, it's very finicky, that whole mechanic, with how just pushing a block lightly, like, you just have to put a little bit of pressure on the stick, but I find that sometimes even when you do just put a little bit of pressure on the stick, he still pushes it, like, super far. But there we go. We got all three. Now we can call Rebecca, and we can make our way back into the facility and finally place these three tablets into their spot. Now I just want to be careful about what I take with us. Okay, let me put all of these into one stack here. All of these, not the ink ribbons, ugh, but the magnum ammo here. We're gonna leave that, obviously, because we don't even have the magnum yet, so it's really no point. I'm going to give some shotgun ammo to Rebecca because she's gonna take the Billy's gonna take the shotgun, I think, right? I'm just gonna split up because I'm noticing that I checked the map earlier when, you know, making sure I had the health to take on the leech mineral area, right? And I noticed that I have a whole bunch of inkerbins and that just sitting all around, and I want to make sure that I just put them all into one stack so that when we move everything from the training facility to the next couple areas within the game, it's, you know, all ready and all set, and I don't actually have to go around on a whole, you know, wild chase here collecting everything and putting it into one stack. I want to make sure it's all ready and prepared. So here we have our final stack of inkerbins, I believe. 15 of them. Yeah, because I only save once for every episode, so we're gonna have a huge stack of inkerbins by the end, way more than we'll actually need. Right. So I have everything I think I need here. The grenade launcher, and I'm obviously gonna take the rounds as well to make sure I can do this boss fight successfully. I might even just go into this boss fight pistolless or handgunless and just use the shotgun and the grenade launcher, which should be enough. I mean, the boss fight's not too hard. I'm more worried about health than actually running out of ammo, because I know for a fact that I should have the ammo to do this. It's not too bad of a fight. So yeah, I think I'm gonna give Rebecca the handgun. Give her all of this. Leave this, we don't need it. Shouldn't need this as well. I think that's all we really need. Maybe a first aid spray, although do we even have a first aid spray? Oh my god, that's not what I meant to do. I just meant to look at the map. Where's herbs all we have? Yikes. I thought we were actually doing a lot better in health than we actually are. This is concerning. Oh gosh. I definitely want to take those napalm grenades as well, but I won't have enough space. You know what? I might actually just leave the regular grenades are done because... Oh, okay, there's a first aid spray we can make there. Good thing I saved that. Do we have two empty slots as Rebecca? We sure do not. I just have to exchange that and then make it and then give it... Okay, yeah, I got this. A lot of inventory managing. It's one of the main problems with this game, and I know not only I, but a lot of people share. It can be very difficult at times. I mean, you'd think with 12 slots it would be easier, but because you have to manage two characters, the 12 slots only really feel like 6, because you're trying to keep health for both characters, right? I feel so stupid, because I keep saying, like, I get, like, stuttering, but it's just because, like, I want to make sure I'm actually doing this right. Take the shotgun. Leave this here with a single herb. Take these napalm grenades and that. Should...
Let's regroup.
Yeah, okay, regroup. And that should be good. Let me just take a look at both. Yeah, okay, I think we're ready. I think we have the supplies to do this. I'm pretty confident in my ability to take this on. I mean, I'm obviously a little concerned just because I only save once every episode, so if I mess this up, I could be in a lot of trouble, but I'm pretty confident, as mentioned, but I will be leaving Billy here so that I can take on these critters without Billy firing off, you know, shotgun and grenade rounds, which are, of course, very important. Here, there's kind of like a glitch in the fact that these bugs won't actually go past this, so we can just kind of keep shooting them and they won't attack us, so it's kind of just a glitch I like to take advantage of and use every single time. But these guys are actually pretty tough. I'm just realizing they are taking a lot of my handgun ammo, I'm sure. On the last handgun shot, we did this. Nice. Let's go. I was looking at the map earlier, and we actually do have a red herb in that room right there, which means that I can come back for that later and make a first aid spray using the other green herb I have down there. So, yeah. I'm not too screwed when it comes to health. I'm doing alright, but I just want to make my way here while playing as Rebecca, because Rebecca's the one we're going to need to play as, because she's the one who has all the tablets in her inventory. I'm actually pretty hyped and excited about the next couple of areas within the game, because I mean, I do think that the train and the facility are pretty cool, but you know, I think the next couple of areas, I don't know if they're necessarily better, but I'm definitely pretty excited to check them out. That's the tablet of Unity put in place. Next up, the Discipline tablet, and I believe after that it's Obedience, and then all three of them will be in place, and we'll be given access to the next area within the game, which I am super stoked about, as mentioned. That's all of them there. Now, this is the sucky part about this. So, as you saw, the whole observatory here just dropped. But basically what that means is that this room doesn't lead back to the third floor. It actually leads back to the second floor. And outside these doors are some eliminators. And I'm not looking forward to that, because those are, as mentioned, the most annoying enemy within, you know, Resident Evil history, I'd almost argue. I mean, they're, you know, jumping all around and they are quite... See, when it comes to small and annoying enemies in games, usually what makes them not so bad is that they usually have really low health bars, but, you know, the Eliminators are an exception, you know, despite, like, you know, their small size, they have quite a lot of health, so they are, you know, pretty difficult to take out, because, like, you know, they'll be jumping around and missing all your shots, and when you do finally land a nice shotgun shot, they'll just get right back up and take a couple more instead of going down, so it's like, I am not looking forward to having to leave through there and fight more Eliminators. Not looking forward to moving all my items, but I mean, it must be done, because honestly, some of those items we left back there are pretty important, and we're actually gonna have to go back there very, very soon, because we actually need the hook shot. Now, I'm wondering if I should do that now or if I should do that later. You know what, I'm actually gonna do it now. No, I'm not sure, actually. Oh my gosh, yikes. Yeah, I really don't know. Yeah, I don't, you know what, actually, I'll do it later, okay. I don't want to do that now, because it would just be a whole, I would just have to manage my inventory again, because we're like full on Rebecca, on my Billy's end, it would just be a whole thing, but. We're gonna split up and have Rebecca go through here. And then we're gonna switch back to Billy. Head down here, and then make our way through these doors. Here we go.